Bro, I gotta tell you guys another story about something I stole.
No.
Yo, homie.
You just unlocked the memory. You just unlocked the memory. I was in fifth grade. And I had detention for some reason.
For some reason. Yeah. What, are you
strange,
sure it wasn't for
wacky reason.
It wasn't for stealing, because the stealing happened while I was in detention. So I'm in detention. And in detention, there was this drawer where they like confiscated, you know, phones, you know, Game Boys and whatnot from kids who were playing in class. And I saw a Game Boy in the desk when I went to go turn in my Game Boy. All I'm gonna say is I walked out with two Game Boys.
What? Oh my
God,
that one's actually messed up. Cypher, yeah. you're
I had a problem, man. Listen, I had a problem. I had to go to therapy for it. No, I'm just kidding. I had to go to therapy for that, but I had a stealing problem when I was a kid. I just had to confess, man, because no one has known about this until now.
Oh yeah, no, I'm actually getting you canceled this time. That's too far.
Oh, what the?
Game Boy's too far, bro. Imagine how sad that kid was.
Rat boy.
I also had to somehow convince my parents that I was gifted an extra Game Boy somehow, because they were questioning me.
You are honestly, bro, you're crazy, man.
They were questioning me. They're like, "Where'd you get this?"
What'd you say, bro? What'd you say?
I don't know what I said. I might have said I found it.
I wanted in a bank. You said I wanted in a bank.
In the third grade.
We were playing dice at lunch.
They're like, why does it have someone's name on it? I mean,
yeah, you weren't smart enough to freaking wash out the name, and you were ballsy enough to steal it.
It did have a sticker with a name on it. I ended up scratching the sticker off.
Bro, this guy Jeremy in my chat goes... This guy Jeremy Machaco, Cypher fights old men at grocery stores and steals from children.
Yeah, those aren't rumors anymore that you're spreading, Jack. You're just
oh my god.
This is confirming the truth.
Yeah, man, maybe that was us. Maybe the reason why I always spread rumors that you'd sold cigarettes to kids and stuff like that is because it's true.
I told you guys about the grade book.
You unlocked the memory.
I told you guys about the grade book story.
No.
So we before they had like online grades, they teachers had a grade book and they would put their grades in. And I was like a straight A student, but I was gonna get a B in this class. And what I did was during lunch, I went into the classroom, took the grade book, and hid it. So all our grades reset, but no, the teacher just thought she lost it. Nothing happened. But then later in the semester, I was like, my grades were slipping in that class again. So I did it again, but this time the teacher searched all our bags. But I was smart enough to put it in the ceiling. You know those ceilings that you can kind of push in?
Yes, I do.
So I push in the ceiling.
Dude, what an absolute deviant.
And both grade books are in that ceiling. And I went back to that school 5 years later because my brother was there. And I went to go check. I went to the bathroom, popped the ceiling open, and they were still there. And I think that was like 10 years ago. Or maybe, yeah, it was like 10 years ago. So I'm pretty sure if I go, they're still there. I don't know why anybody would check the ceiling.
I mean this with all due respect. You need to seek help.
Yeah.
You need help, man.
Stop it. Get some help.
So check it, man. So Cypher, man.
But like, I'm going to blame my parents for that one because like, I was a straight A student and if I got a B, they would take away like my computer and TV privileges. And I just felt I was desperate.
Situation.
I was desperate. Yeah. If they didn't pressure me into getting good grades, I would have not done that.
Cypher's a straight menace, dude.
And at this point, I wouldn't be surprised if you, like, quite literally, like, kicked grandmothers when they're across the street.
Yeah, no, dude, 100%, dude. Yo, Cypher's the guy, he'll help a grandma cross the street, and then when she's halfway there, just leave her and then run.
No.
And then, good luck.
Just earlier, I was like, guys, I'm a law-abiding citizen. I was saying, if I go somewhere and they require, like, you know, mask or vaccine, I'm just going to provide it. I'm not going to put up a fuss. And someone was like, you're a law-abiding citizen, but you did all this?
Oh, man.
That is so truly terrible.
Oh, this guy has a heart. This guy made a heart on top of the...
Well, now what I'm wondering, Tyler 1 and Tyler 2, is are we going to get canceled for associating with Cypher right now?
Maybe. Nah, but honestly, like, I'm not going to be that strict as a parent because I feel like being too strict caused me to do some crazy things as a kid that I wouldn't have done if my parents were a little more chill.
Dang, someone stole the vault key card and left. So stupid.
I just wiped a whole squad. I'm a fucking god.
Someone said it was an AI squad. No, no.
No, it was not an AI squad.
No, I know. Someone in my chat is just trolling.
I know. I get it. Funny.
Hey,
Jack, you literally have probably been confused and mixed up as a bot for literally probably 100 times.
Yeah, I can't hear you, bro. I can't hear you, man. Sorry, I was too busy looting the whole vault by myself and taking all the loot.
Yeah. Good for you, man. You know what else is good for you?
Hold on, I gotta mute. All right, I'm back.
He's nuts on your chin.
Yeah, all right, hold on, I gotta
mute. Yeah, nice try. Yo, that's actually hilarious. Yo, maybe that old man was onto something, dude. Maybe he saw through you. Maybe he knew.
Oh, man.
He disguised it as racism, but in reality, he knew. You're the type of guy who
Cypher stole
Game Boys.
You probably thought I was stealing the groceries. I was robbing Publix.
They deliberately spilled ice to try to trip the elderly in Florida. Hid grade books to commit fraud in his education.
Why the hell are you guys fucking addicted to Coney Crossroads? The Towers is in the zone and our bounty's there, and yet here's SypherPK leading the charge to Coney.
I'm actually eating my Chick-fil-A while auto running.
This is ridiculous, bro. I see, dude. Oh my god. Are you gonna be here? If I push these guys, are you gonna be here?
Mm-hmm.
Man, they reset hit matchmaking or something.
Yeah, let me ask you a question, Cypher.
What's up?
You go to the grocery store, right? You finish mm-hmm. checking out, you walk out with your cart. You
no, I put the cart away. I put the cart away.
Where does your cart go?
Yeah, I put it cart away. I put the cart where it's supposed to go.
Hmm. Okay. All right, let me ask you this. Growing up, there's a present under the Christmas tree that Santa forgot to label. Could be anyone's gift.
Oh, he puts Ollie on it. Instantly, dude.
Okay.
No, better yet,
someone said he stole
tape.
The cart.
Better yet, he takes tape, dude. He puts it over his name that his mom wrote, right? His mom
okay, okay, no. I got another story. I got it. You just reminded me of something else I did.
Another?
Yeah. This one's bad too. This one's bad.
What? Oh, there's a guy on. I thought it was you. Two guys just randomly here. One guy I lasered, the other guy made no noise.
Yo, why is the soccer skin sliding like that?
No, you saw that?
This next one is bad. So,
let's hear it, bro.
We had science fair in school. And once you got to middle school, then you could like your project, if it was good enough, it could like move on to like regionals and then state finals and whatever. But just I was in elementary, and elementary, when you made it to the science fair, like when you made it out of like the first stage of your school, at most you can get a first place, second, or a third place. But multiple people can get first, second, and third. It's basically a grade. Once you're done presenting, You go to this room, and then everybody like waits, and then you go and check on your science fair project to see if you got first, second, or third. I went real like once they opened the gates to let people go check on their project to see if they got first, second, or third. I went and I saw that I had gotten a third, and I was so disappointed that I grabbed the first place ribbon from the person next to me and swapped it, and I saw the kid show up to his project, see that he got a third place ribbon, and look so sad.
You literally probably robbed that kid of going to Yale.
No, I did not.
You robbed that kid of.
I did not.
Going into science.
By the way, guys, all these crimes have been done before the age of 13. Okay.
Wait. I need to really set the stage here.
Another big father, Jack.
Cypher did that, right? And demoralized that child who was so bullish on getting into science and pursuing his dreams that he quite literally stopped a kid from getting into science and potentially discovering the cure for cancer or, you know, helping us get to space just so that you could boost your ego. You sick son of a bitch.
It's not like that, bro.
Yo, why are all these AI, bro? What is happening?
It's not like that.
Feels like that
guy
was nail on the head.
No, the web was blocking right there.
Someone just brought up a great point. What if the old man that tried to fight you in Publix was the dad of the kid that you stole the Game Boy from, and it was his redemption arc?
Cypher, you got a problem.
I had a problem.
Okay, so please let me know, when was it fixed?
I got into severe gambling addiction when I was a kid in RuneScape, and it got out of hand, and then I basically intervention was staged. Oh, that looks so cool.
Wait, what? Oh,
my family staged an intervention about my gambling addiction, and I learned that I needed to go a different path.
I want to say that I think you're a person, but you might be the worst person that I've ever met in my whole life.